Floyd Mayweather says he's going to be more aggressive against Conor McGregor. Max, are you buying it?
Yes, I am, because Floyd can do whatever he wants in this fight. And it's not even really about being aggressive. It's about putting on a show. Floyd doesn't want to end this fight very early and everyone goes home disappointed and it's a total mismatch. He wants to put on a show. I expect him to carry Conor McGregor several rounds before stopping him. But if Conor gets super aggressive and forces Mayweather to take him out earlier than Mayweather would like, that's what'll happen. I've seen Mayweather fight aggressively in the past. He's always been a boxer, a careful boxer. There are some kind of fighters that like everything to be perfect before they throw a punch. Floyd is one of those kind of fighters, but Floyd also is smart enough to know how to make everything perfect in terms of the geometry of the fight, where he is, where his opponent is, who's in punching distance and range, and who has the angle and all that, and it's usually him. So he can control all those things in a fight, but I've seen him, you know, put up his hands high, fight behind a high guard, elbows tucked, and walk world-class fighters down, including Zab Judah. Zab, who's a very talented southpaw and recently had just lost the undisputed or the lineal welterweight championship before he fought Floyd. Zab had a good first four rounds against Floyd. And in the corner, Roger Mayweather, Floyd's uncle and trainer and former champion himself, said, walk him down. And Floyd put up his hands and tucked his elbows and just walked Zab Judah down and beat him up the rest of the way. Floyd can fight aggressively if he chooses. I expect him to do that at times against Conor, but the big picture is not that. It's that he's going to put on a show. He's going to want people to leave happy in case there's another $100 million plus payday out there for him that he wants people to buy in the not too distant future.
Max, I'm going to defer to you on this by asking you a question, because tell me what you think about this analogy. When I look at Conor McGregor against Floyd, you know who I think about? Floyd against Ricky Hatton. That's what I think about. Now, obviously, McGregor's a southpaw. McGregor's a southpaw, whereas Hatton was not. But I also think that that Mayweather was patient. Hatton came out very, very aggressive, tried to shove him around, tried to muscle him, and et cetera, recognized that he couldn't do it. Floyd ultimately picked him apart before catching him with a check hook, you know, making his head fall into the daggone corner post and fall down and all of this other stuff. I view this fight as being that. I think that Conor McGregor being the bigger, stronger guy and accustomed to violence because of being in the UFC, I think he comes out and he tries to be the aggressor. He quickly recognizes that Floyd is virtually impossible to hit, while Floyd goes about the business of meticulously picking him apart. The power isn't necessarily there where it's going to be a one-punch knockout or a combination that ultimately puts him to sleep early. But I do believe, because of his boxing brilliance and excellence, along with the wizardry that he's going to put on display, because he'll make Conor expend energy, missing and what have you, he will wear him down more so than it would be a quick early knockout. To that you say what, Max?
I think the Ricky Hatton comparison is very interesting, because the idea is that Floyd's toughest fight was against Jose Luis Castillo, a really, really good, if not great, lightweight champion involved in the greatest fight I've ever seen against Diego Corrales, which Castillo lost. But Castillo gave Floyd his closest fight. A lot of people thought Castillo won, Floyd got the decision. Never mind, it was Floyd's first fight at lightweight, and Castillo was the lightweight champion of the world. Floyd had just jumped from junior lightweight to lightweight, and in his first fight takes on the best guy and still wins the fight and then beats him easily in a rematch. But what people saw from that fight is Castillo didn't give him space. He put him up against the ropes. He turned it into a kind of ugly fight. They were ignoring Castillo's skill, which was considerable. And then the thought was, well, if you do that to Floyd, you know, you can overtax his defense just with a high volume of punches. And that's what Ricky Hatton tried to do. Ricky Hatton lost just about every round. People mistakenly thought that fight was competitive. He lost just about every round, which is why he got knocked out, because Floyd broke him down, beat him up, and knocked him out, ran him into the check hook that you mentioned. But even Ricky Hatton fighting like that, Ricky Hatton was the champion of the world, the undefeated junior welterweight champion of the world. He beat Costa Zou for the title. Costa Zou is a Hall of Fame caliber fighter, was among the best pound for pound fighters in the world.
Zab Judah would confirm that, Max, about Costa Zou.
Right, right. Yes. Costa Zoo knocked out Zab Judah. Exactly right. You know your boxing, Stephen A., mm-hmm. in two rounds. So when a guy like Ricky Hatton does that, that doesn't mean Conor McGregor can do the same thing in his professional debut. What the champion, the undefeated lineal junior welterweight champion of the world did, who beat a guy like Costa Zoo to get the title. But even if Conor could do that, Floyd won every round and knocked him out.
Max.
I don't expect Conor to be able to fight to box on a Ricky Hatton level.